Hey guys, good morning. Welcome back to our channel, the Eaton Squad. My name is Addie. So for today's video, let's discuss the confusing world of rules by the IATF. As we all know, the shortened quarantine has been implemented, but I've seen a lot of complaints that they were denied for the shortened quarantine even if they have their vaccination card. So let's talk about that. Details coming right up. Behind closed doors, I'm a fool for your love. So let's get this out of the way. Unfortunately, there were a lot of travelers who were denied for shortened quarantine implemented by the IATF. Started October 8 of 2021, a lot of inbound travelers to the Philippines were surprised that they were denied for shortened quarantine because of the vaccination card that they have presented. Unfortunately, the Bureau of Quarantine is requiring all travelers to present the yellow card or the International Certificate of Vaccination. This is the yellow card that they are looking for. Now, the only problem is most of the countries does not issue the ICV or the International Certificate of Vaccination, but the white card, which is your vaccination card. I've also heard that you can just print out your digital copy or the digital vaccination certificate from where you got your vaccination. But I am going to show you guys on this video others that have presented that, travelers that have presented their CDC vaccination card, their digital vaccination certificate coming from their doctors or coming from a hospital or clinic where they got their vaccination but still denied for the shortened quarantine. So I don't really know what IATF is up to again, because they implement such a thing, but when it gets implemented, it's like, no, we need this, we need that, and it's very hard to secure it. It's very hard to find it. And worse, most countries are not really issuing that type of yellow card. So in short, at the moment, it's really hard to prove if you are fully vaccinated or not, because even if you have those documents that I already mentioned, you will still be denied for shortened quarantine but go through the 7 days quarantine in a hotel or facility and finish the remaining 7 days at home quarantine. So during the Talk to the People meeting by the President of the Philippines, Rodrigo Duterte, along with his cabinet member, Secretary Harry Roque actually addressed this. And let's listen to his comment, or let's listen to his statement when it comes to the version of the ICV or the International Certificate of Vaccination. But I will be putting an English subtitle on this video. So let's listen what he's about to say on this new implementation.
Yeah, hinihikayat na natin ngayon ang pagtanggap ng mga equivalent po ng vaccert.ph na inisyu ng iba't ibang mga bansa, pero this is on the basis of reciprocity. So po ang bansang nag-issue po ng certificate ay kinikilala po ang ating vaccert.ph, kinikilala po natin yung kanilang vaccert.ph din, o yung counterpart na ini-issue nila sa kanilang mga bayan.
So it clearly states that he said the counterpart of vaccert.ph that we are doing here to those who are vaccinated here in the Philippines. So it's really confusing, especially to those travelers who came home starting October the 8th. And up to date, I can still read those horror experience of our travelers to the Philippines that they cannot avail the shortened quarantine because the document or the vaccination card or the digital copy that they have presented to the Bureau of Quarantine verification is not acceptable, especially the CDC card. If you are coming from the United States, the CDC card, that white card given to you after you get vaccinated, your vaccination card is not acceptable over here. So I am going to show you guys the experience of some travelers to the Philippines. And here are some of the comments that I have read. My husband landed in Manila on October 10. He is vaccinated, presented his vaccination card and digital copy. He gets swab on the 7th day. So meaning his vaccination card and digital copy of his vaccination was not accepted, meaning he was denied for shortened quarantine because, like the comment said, his swab is on the 7th day. So pretty much, he belongs to the unvaccinated category or the first dose category. So I don't really know what paperwork they really need to be able to be verified as fully vaccinated from abroad, because if you are fully vaccinated in the Philippines, you shouldn't be worrying about this mess, because you can just access everything from VaxCertPH. But unfortunately, to those who get vaccinated abroad, I am in no words what really the IATF implementation or the IATF resolution pertains when it comes to documentation that you need to show the Bureau of Quarantine verification staff to avail the shortened quarantine. Let's hear another comment. Just wanted to share my mom and my wife's experience. They left yesterday from New York via Asiana Airlines and arrived tonight at NAIA. They asked for their vaccination proof and showed both digital QR code, New York vaccination passport, and CDC card. Got denied for the shortened 5 days quarantine. It was very swift and fast. And seems like you are auto-denied if you are coming from the U.S. Can you believe they are asking them for their polo verification? We don't have polo here in the States. Also, alternative to the polo vaccination is the ICV yellow card, which is impossible to get your doctor to sign on because they did not perform your vaccination. This is very disappointing, knowing we are vaccinated and are denied the privilege and be treated like unvaccinated. How can you encourage people to get vaccinated? Wow, that is just bizarre. You have the vaccination card, the digital copy, now they want the yellow card, which the U.S. is not really issuing that. I've heard you can purchase that in Amazon and have your physician fill it out and sign it. But even that, it's not an assurance that your vaccination status will be accepted. So nobody really knows what their category, nobody really knows what document they really need to be accepted for shortened quarantine and to be verified as fully vaccinated, especially coming from abroad. So it's really confusing why they would implement such rules, such new guidelines, but in return, they will not accept everything, even if you have exerted all efforts to secure that particular document just to prove that you are fully vaccinated. I don't know what the Philippine government, particularly the IATF, is really looking for to just really prove that your documents are not fake, that you are fully vaccinated abroad, because this is what they are trying to avoid fake documents and everything. But having the vaccination card, the white card, the digital copy, I think that's enough proof already that you are fully vaccinated. Now you want the yellow card, which, for example, the U.S. is not really issuing. So everybody is left hanging on what really is the proper documentation to show your people at the airport to avail for the 5 days quarantine. But this comment that I am going to show you is the most interesting, because she said, "Kakauwi ko lang kagabi, tinanggap naman digital vaccination certificate ko from France." So she's coming from France. I also read others came from Germany, from Italy, or any European countries, because I think they have their own ICV over there, or the yellow card, that were accepted and they were able to avail the shortened quarantine. So I don't really know if it pertains to the country you are coming from. If you're coming from the U.S., you're automatically denied. I'm not trying to do the blaming games, but it looks like that's what's going on at the NAIA airport. So this particular traveler came from France and just showed her digital vaccination certificate was accepted. The digital vaccination certificate contains a QR code. So, like others said, if you have the QR code on that digital vaccination certificate, it should be good. But the problem is, with those comments that we have read already, they as well have digital vaccination certificate with QR codes, but still got denied. So, We don't really know what game is this again by the IATF. It's not funny. It's actually good news already that you guys don't have to stay at the hotel anymore for longer quarantine. It was shortened and you can just continue your quarantine at home. But the problem is, it's really hard to get verified to be fully vaccinated from abroad. Please do me a favor to all our subscribers, especially to those who just arrived in the Philippines on or after this implementation was announced last October 8th. Please comment below what are your experience, if your documents were accepted, if your vaccination card were accepted, if your digital vaccination certificate were accepted, or did you need to purchase a yellow card from Amazon and have your physician sign it and show it to the BOQ staff at the airport? Were these accepted? So please comment it down below so we can use this as reference to all travelers who are coming to the Philippines very soon so we can give them a heads up of what's going on. So I'm so sorry guys, I myself is also confused on what really is this implementation is all about because it's useless. Like they said, I am fully vaccinated, but the Philippines is treating me as unvaccinated because I get denied for shortened quarantine because the document that I presented to them or submitted to them is not enough for them. So this video is a heads up to all travelers to the Philippines that those documents that they presented were denied. So I'm not really sure what they are really trying to ask, or I'm not really sure what requirements they really want for a particular traveler to avail for a shortened quarantine. I will keep an eye on this implementation, and as the days goes by, probably there will be more improvement to this new guideline. I will be seeing more experience of our travelers that this particular document is accepted already, this and that, and I will definitely keep you guys posted if there's any changes of the documents that they will accept to prove your status as fully vaccinated from abroad. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please like and share this video with your friends and family. It will really help out our channel. And if you are new to our channel, welcome. We do travel updates, we do immigration updates, and any travel related updates to the Philippines. If you are interested on this, please consider subscribing and don't forget to hit that notification bell so you will be notified every time we have new uploads. And to our subscribers who's been here with us since day one, we thank you guys so much. We really appreciate your support to our channel, The Eaton Squad. I hope to see you guys in our next travel update. Stay safe, stay healthy, and God bless everyone. Bye.